मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ कार्तिक सैनी. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स, दैट इज थ्योरी ऑफ डिमांड. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल लुक व्हाट इज डिमांड. हियर डिमांड मींस अ डिजायर्ड क्वांटिटी ऑफ अ कमोडिटी एंड विलिंगनेस टू स्पेंड एंड एबिलिटी टू परचेज एट गिवन प्राइस. वी कैन से डिमांड मींस इट्स अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ डिजायर, ability to purchase means purchasing power, plus willingness to spend. Desire means I need that. For example, I want to buy a car. I want to buy a sports car. It's very expensive, but it's my desire to have a sports car. And I have ability. I have money to buy that sports car, or one or two car, whatever it is. I have ability to purchase. And I am willing to spend. I just want the car. That's my desire. I have amount of money. I have that sum of money to buy that car. That is my ability. And I am now ready to spend a big amount to purchase that car. That is my willingness. Here the word commodity means goods and services. Goods and services. We can say a desired quantity of a commodity. Willingness to spend and ability to purchase at given price. At given price. That is demand. For example, I want to have a mobile, but it's of 20,000, but I don't think that it is worth 20,000. It is worth 20,000. So the demand will be called when I am satisfied with that given price. When I am satisfied with that given price and willing to spend. And willing to spend at that particular for that particular product or services at that given price, that will be my demand. Demand can be of two types. First of all, we will talk about individual demand. When I am talking about an individual person, demand was individual person. Or individual household. What demand of a family? Household family. Okay. Demand of an individual person or individual. That is the individual demand. For example, Mr. X. His demand is 100 units of whatever product. For example, 100 units of 100 kg of wheat. So this is an individual demand. A demand of an individual customer, a demand of an individual person or individual household. For example, we are talking about Mr. X and his family. Mr. X and his family. So this is an individual demand. Whereas when we are talking about market demand, demand of a market demand. So we will sum up the demand of more than one customer, more than one household, more than more than one person. For example, Mr. X is buying 100 units, 100 kg of wheat. Mr. Y is buying 150 kg. Mr. Z is buying 50 kg. So this will be my 200 kg of market demand. So the many persons make a market. Market is made up of so many individuals. Now, individual person create a market. A market is created by so many individuals, so many households. For example, Mr. X, Mr. Y, Mr. Z are part of a society, a part of a market. And when their demands are summed up, when their demands are added, that is a market demand. For example, he is demanding 100 kg, he is 50, Mr. Z 50. So when we sum up the demands of all three individuals, that will be my market demand, that is 200 kg. Now we will talk about the determinants or the factors which affects the individual demand. First of all, the price of the commodity or the goods or services. For example, if a price of a tomato is increasing, so definitely its demand will decrease. Earlier you were buying tomatoes at rupees 30 per kg. So you are demanding 2 kg, for example 2 kg. Now the price of tomatoes increases to 50 rupees per kg. 50 kg, now you are demanding single kg. That means if the price is increasing, the demand is decreasing. Similarly, when the price of any commodity decreases, its demand will increase. Which shows that there is an inverse relation between price and demand. Inverse relation, that is opposite. If price is increasing, then demand will decrease. If price is decreasing, demand will increase. Okay. Now the second factor is, that is price of relative. First of all, we will talk about what is relative. Related goods can be of two types. First one is substitute good. नाम से ही पता चल रहा है, substitute means हम जिसको एक की जगह दूसरे को हम यूज कर सके. फॉर एग्जाम्पल टी और कॉफी. We can substitute tea with a coffee or coffee with a tea. For example, if the price of tea is increasing, so maybe demand of coffee will increase. How? For example, I prefer to have a tea, but the price of tea is increasing, so I'll switch to coffee, or the substitute of tea. Coffee is a substitute of tea. So for example, I'm getting tea at very high prices, and comparatively the price of the coffee is lower than the tea. So I'll switch my demand to coffee. If the price of tea is increasing, so my demand for coffee will increase, because I'll switch my interest or my preference from tea to coffee. This means this states a direct relation. Direct relation between price and demand of the substitute good. Okay. And similarly, if the price will decrease, the demand will also decrease. The price of normal good or the tea is decreasing, then demand for coffee will also decrease. Substitute good, clearly demand will come to zero. Now we will talk about complementary goods. Complementary goods are those goods which complement each other, like car and petrol. Because without petrol, you can't run your car. Without car, petrol is of no use. If the price of petrol is increasing, so it will directly affect the demand of the car. How? Price bada raha hai. So maintenance cost car की बढ़ेगी. Daily हम petrol डलवाते हैं car में, fuel tank full कराते हैं जब भी हमको ज़रूरत होती है. अगर उसका price petrol का बहुत ज़्यादा high होगा, तो हमें car को maintain करना भी थोड़ा सा मुश्किल हो सकता है ना. So this means if the price of a complementary goods is increasing, so the demand for the complementary good, the second complementary good, may increase due to the change in price of first good. वैसे ही if price of petrol is decreasing, so it may increase the demand of the car. This shows inverse relation between complementary goods. Their price and demand. Price and demand में inverse relation show करता है complementary goods. Next one is income of the buyer. The selection is the selection of the product is directly dependent upon the income of the consumer, income of the buyer. It goods are categorized here. The goods are categorized in two categories. First one is normal. Second one is inferior. On the basis of income, we select the good. Inferior means cheap goods or of low quality. Yeah. If the income of the buyer is increasing, so demand for the normal goods. Normal goods are those goods which we use in daily life. Normally we use. They are of normal quality which we use in our home. If income of the buyer is increasing, so the demand for the normal goods will also increase. And if the income of the buyer is decreasing, so demand will also increase. And he will switch to inferior goods. Okay, now we will talk about inferior goods. Inferior goods are those goods which are of, we can say cheap goods, which are of low quality and low price. Simple baat hai, if the quality is low, the price will be also low. If income is decreasing, if the income of the buyer is decreasing, so demand for the inferior goods may increase. Kaise, how it works? If my income is getting decreased, so I'll switch my interest or switch my preference. I'll change my preference from normal goods to inferior goods. Inferior goods, because I am getting those goods at very low price. If my income is decreasing, so I'll try to get the goods which are of low price. So demand for the inferior goods may increase. Similarly, if the income is increasing, so demand for inferior goods may decrease, because now I'll switch my interest to normal goods. If my income is increasing, so I'll switch my interest to normal goods. This shows inverse relation. Income but कम हो रही है, demand बढ़ रही है. Income बढ़ रही है, demand कम हो रही है. We have direct relation. Here direct relation between income and demand. Okay. Now the next one is taste and preference. Next one is taste and preference. Many times, if main price increase or price decrease, demand remains constant, because this is due to my taste and preference. Ho sakta hai, I love to have tea. The price of tea may increase or decrease. Demand won't get affected. Demand remains constant. For example, if my preference changes to coffee, if my preference changes from tea to coffee, this may affect demand for tea may decrease and demand for coffee may increase. Okay, so this is directly dependent upon the taste and preference of the buyer. How demand is affected by taste and preference of the buyer. The next one is expected change in price of goods in future. That means, अगर मुझे लगता है कि future में किसी भी, अगर मुझे उम्मीद है, expected है मुझे कि किसी भी goods की price में change आएगा, उस हिसाब से at present मेरी demand में क्या फर्क आता है, वो बढ़ भी सकती है, it may increase or it may decrease. For example, in the lockdown, we have noticed. We have expected the price of the grocery item. May increase in future. So at present, at current, we demanded a lot. When our demand was increased. मुझे पता था, मुझे लग रहा था कि इन फ्यूचर डिमांड प्राइस जो है ग्रोसरी आइटम्स की वो आगे जाके बढ़ सकती है. द नियर फ्यूचर द प्राइसेस ऑफ द ग्रोसरी आइटम्स में increase. So I'll make stop for today. I'll make stop today at the current period में मेरी डिमांड क्या होगी, इंक्रीज हो जाएगी, क्योंकि मुझे पता है कि आगे जाके मेरी प्राइस जो है ग्रोसरी आइटम्स जो बढ़ सकती है, तो मैं अभी ही ज़्यादा डिमांड कर लेता हूँ. आई मीन दैट मीन्स मैं अभी ज़्यादा स्टॉक करके रख लेता हूँ. आई विल स्टॉक द ग्रोसरी आइटम्स फॉर फ्यूचर एट करेंट प्राइस, एट करेंट डे और एट करेंट टाइम पीरियड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ इन द फ्यूचर आई एम एक्सपेक्टिंग द प्राइस ऑफ द मोबाइल, price of mobile may decrease in Diwali offer. I am expecting this. The price of the mobile may decrease. The fall in price in the fall in price of mobile due to Diwali offer. I am expecting this because I am talking about the future. So at present, I want demand or my demand for those goods may be increased. It may decrease because I know I am expecting that the price will fall, so I'll buy that product when the price is lowest or the price is minimum. At the current period, my demand for that particular product may decrease because I am expecting that in the future the price of that particular product may fall. Okay. Now we have completed the determinants and factor affecting individual demand. Now we are talking about the market demand.